Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please put your hands together for the tNCC Kidz Christmas presentation!
Hey man, why are you sitting here all by yourself? Why aren't you over there celebrating with your friends on this lovely Christmas day?
I don't know, I'm feeling a bit out of it. I was thinking, what is Christmas all about? Is it about the colourful lights, or the pretty decor, or lots and lots of presents? What does it really mean?
Come, let me show you.
God has sent me as he has found favour with you. You have a baby boy who will be king forever and ever! And you are to give the name Jesus.
What do you mean? I'm not even married. My boyfriend and I also, how can I have a baby?
The Lord works in mysterious ways. The Holy Spirit will do his thing. And your son will be the Son of God.
Like that? Okay, I am the Lord's servant. Whatever you say, so be it.
Joseph, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife.
Why should I take her as my wife? She's gonna have a baby. Definitely not mine. Me and her also, we never... How am I gonna have this baby?
Mary's gonna have God's son. You are to give him the name Jesus. And he will save the world from their sins. He will be Emmanuel, God with us.
Oh, I see, lor. Okay, I'll take Mary as my wife.
Can I listen to your story too?
Sure. So, Mary and Joseph had to travel to Bethlehem, their hometown, for a government census. And Mary was heavily pregnant at that time.
Joseph, I am very tired and it's getting late. We need to find somewhere to stay.
All right, let's stop at the closest inn.
May we have a room, please?
We have no room. Get out of here.
No room.
May we have a room, please?
We have full house today.
Excuse me.
No room.
Sorry, we are fully booked.
Any room, please?
What you want? No more room.
My wife is pregnant!
I don't think you find any room in this town. You shouldn't be traveling this late in the evening. If you don't mind, I have a stable out back. That isn't the most comfortable place, but it'll be a roof overhead. It has animals and it's warm, and there are plenty of dogs.
We'll take it!
Well then, follow me.
What? A stable? Who sleeps with animals and straw and shh?
Don't worry, Mary. I know that God is with us. At least we have a roof over our head.
Joseph, I don't feel very well. I am having this pain. I think it's time for the baby to be born.
Meanwhile, some shepherds were tending their flocks at night when suddenly an angel appeared right before them.
Behold, I bring good news of great joy, for today in the city of David there is born for you a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in the manger.
Praise to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men.
Yes, God of Bethlehem, and see what the angels have told us about.
Thanks for the good news. Let's faster go.
Look at the star. Look how bright it is.
It's a sign. It's a wonderful sign. The King of the Jews is born.
Let us go and worship him.
Gifts. We need gifts.
Oh. I will give him gold.
Frankincense will be my gift.
My gift will be special. It will be myrrh.
Let us put these gifts into special boxes to present the new king.
What strange gifts to give a baby? What do they mean?
Well, gold is something people give to the king because it's very precious and valuable and fit for royalty.
How about Frankenstein?
No, you mean frankincense? It's incense used in worship. Somehow, they knew that this baby was the son of God and worthy of worship. As for myrrh, it is a type of fragrant oil that is used to embalm dead bodies.
Embalm? But Jesus was just a baby. That's such a weird gift to give a baby who was just starting off in life.
Well, it was another prophetic gift by the wise men. Somehow, they knew that this little baby was born with one mission in life, to die for the sins of the world, because all of us have sinned and deserve to die. But God loved us so much, he came down from heaven as a helpless little baby who would grow up to take our place and punishment, and to die for our sins on the cross, so that all of us can be part of his family.
Wow, that's incredible! Totally!
So you see, when we celebrate Christmas, we are remembering the very first Christmas day, when hope was born in a tiny stable in Bethlehem. When we exchange gifts, it reminds us of the ultimate gift of God given to us, so that we all can have everlasting life and life to the full.
Thank you for sharing. All of this just makes the celebration of Christmas so much more meaningful and very special. Thank you, Jesus, for coming to save us all and to give us a real reason to celebrate.
Yay!
Wow! Wow!